Coming up on Wildcats Media News, LC talks right to life.
Everyone's right to life from conception to natural death.
A week full of performances.
This is the first time the audience is going to see all the work we've put in.
And a look at summer movies. That and more on Wildcats Media News.
From Studio A in the Martin Performing Arts Center, this is Wildcats Media News.
Hello and welcome to Wildcats Media News, your weekly campus news source. I'm Mark Klein. First up, a new Students for Life organization is talking about abortion. They held a Right to Life forum here on campus. Wildcats Media's Melody Much has more with what they're trying to tell LC students.
On April 16th, students gathered at Kavanaugh Hall to discuss what exactly it means to have a right to life.
Because there's a lot of information that's might be misleading or just misinformation out there about abortion and about women's real options, you know, who find themselves in a tough situation.
The New Right to Life Club on campus hosted the event as a way to educate students on the issue.
Through education and through community service, but basically changing people's hearts to where in the future, if they ever come across an issue, they have a pro-life perspective on it and that they are able to reach people with kindness and love.
Speakers included employees from Louisiana Right to Life. LC history professor Mrs. Gabrielle Walker also spoke to students about Margaret Sanger and the history of birth control.
Contraception had been legal throughout most of the 19th century, but there were some against public dissemination of contraception information.
President of LC Right to Life, Kaylee Morgan, hopes this event will teach students that everyone has a right to life.
We hope to plan future events that teach the education about right to life, everyone's right to life from conception to natural death. And we also hope to do volunteer work in the community at crisis pregnancy care centers.
Information on how to get involved with the LC Right to Life Club and their upcoming events can be found on their Facebook group, LC Students for Life. For Wildcats Media, I'm Melody Mutt.
The week of April 13th was National Library Week, and LC's library held a number of events to mark the occasion. There were four chances to gain cultural credits at the library to support National Library Week. On Wednesday, students had the chance to listen to three authors speak about their passion for writing. Then on Thursday, Library Director Terry Martin provided a historical tour of the facility, which included a number of pieces of LC history memorabilia.
So we wanted to sort of get people into the library, let them see what we had done, as well as have time when we get like the history, pick up a little history. We had one series that dealt with interviewing authors. We wanted people to see what it took to publish a book. We also have, on Friday, the last week, there's going to be a fun and games type thing, and that's meant just to get people into the library.
This year was the first year LC has celebrated National Library Week in many years, so they hope to polish it and make it even better for next year. If you love to laugh, then you'll love TLC's final production of the school year. Once Upon a Mattress is the musical retelling of the fairy tale The Princess and the Pea that helped make Carol Burnett a star. In TLC's version, Rose Smoke plays the role of the would-be princess who has to pass the test put on to her by the queen, played by Karen Wagley, in order to marry the prince, played by Cullen Chafin. It's also the final TLC production for five seniors: Wagley, Emma Graves, set designer Melody Much, stage manager Becca Unsworth, and director Emily Lansing.
It's been a great experience to be able to work with them for the last time. It's sad to tell everyone goodbye at the end of the year, but it's been a lot of fun just to kind of start with them freshman year all the way to senior year.
Lansing is the first student to direct one of TLC's feature productions. The show runs this weekend and next, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday nights, and Sunday afternoon. Tickets for the LC family are $5. It's a small world after all. And it's where the inspiration came from for the latest Music Squared recital. The duo is made up of LC piano instructor Mayan Cho and her high school classmate from Taiwan, Chow Hung. This was their fourth performance at LC.
This time we had this idea about traveling. So we started finding pieces from different continents, different composers with different time period, and then started from there and found pieces around I mean, it covers Europe, Africa, Asia, America, and almost everywhere.
Music, I think it's fun to do research and to practice and to, yeah, and to perform.
Cho returns during summers to tour with Hung in their home country. Sticking with music, the Louisiana College Chorale brought its year to a close with its annual spring concert. Chorale has been in a year of transition after the departure of popular director Dr. Fred Gilbert. Gilbert's role has been filled this year by one of his protégés, Cameron Weatherford. The spring concert featured a variety of music that Weatherford says complements the talents of this year's singers. Also during the concert, a performance by the a cappella ensemble group, The Grace Notes.
It's amazing for me as a director to always remember that this is the first time the audience is going to see all the work we've put in. And so when I build a concert and program a concert, I'm always thinking about, is there enough variety in this to keep everybody's attention?
Weatherford says Chorale has a great future, and he's hoping that even more students will join the group next school year. And it was a night of worship with the voices of LC. Wildcats Media's Hannah Fleming has the sights and sounds from the event.
Dr. Fred Gilbert loves voices. He was the creator of voices. He's really the heart and soul of it, and the fact that he's not leading voices anymore, it left a huge void.
Now I found you.
It's been one of the most rewarding things to work with a bunch of students. They're not only exceptional vocalists, but they're exceptional at their pursuit of Christ, and I'm just excited about what we've done.
Cause you helped me be strong. There's a change in my life since you came along.
I've been in Voices for 5 years. Voices was one of the reasons I came to Louisiana College. I heard them at a preview day, and I thought I would like to be involved in something like that one day, and little did I know I was going to be in it, you know. It's grown me spiritually, definitely. I mean, having to constantly be on the road, going from church to church, you have to learn to feed yourself and take in the gospel. And it's taught me a lot about just group dynamics and learning to get along with people in spite of whatever's going on. Me and my sister are very close, and then having her with me traveling all the time, there's no one that understands me like my family, so it's been really great. I love it.
Worship. Tonight is a night of worship, and worship is based off what the Lord is worth to us. Every breath, every note, every rhythm, every word is all to communicate to a holy, righteous, omnipotent God.
Coming up after the break, Carolyn Thornton takes a look at sports and Taylor Freet has entertainment. That and more on Wildcats Media News.
We all have a story to tell.
It was almost dark.
Within the Division of Humanities at Louisiana College, qualified teachers train students to tell their stories each day. An English degree helps you write and speak confidently, priceless skills for an employer.
I mean, exactly.
And in our global marketplace, many recruiters are turning directly to humanities majors for their foreign language and multicultural expertise. The Louisiana College Division of Humanities. Write your future today.
Welcome to sports. I'm Carolyn Thornton. The LC softball team enters its final 2 weeks of the season, poised to make a lot of noise in postseason play. The 21st-ranked Lady Cats sweeping Mary Harden Baylor this week with scores of 2-0, 7-4, and 2-1. That clinches the number 3 seed in the upcoming American Southwest Conference Tournament. The Cats getting another shutout pitching performance from freshman Savannah Settle in that first game, improving her record to 14-3 and the team's record to 26-8 overall. Settle has surprised not only the Wildcat fans, but also herself.
I really wasn't expecting to come in to be the number one pitcher. I was kind of expecting to be like number 2 or 3. Coach kind of surprised me on that, but I guess me working as hard as I am, it kind of paid off.
Opponents are hitting just 188 against Settle this year, and she's been especially dominant at home with a 4-0 record, including 4 shutouts. This weekend, LC has its home and season finale, hosting number 2 in the nation, Texas Tyler, with games at 5 p.m. Friday and a doubleheader starting at 1 on Saturday. LC remains 6th in the regional rankings, which has them in position for postseason play.
I feel like we have a really good chance making it to regionals. As long as we keep fighting hard like we have been, I'm pretty sure we're going to make it to regionals.
Meanwhile, the LC baseball team will have to fight hard if the team hopes to make postseason play. The Wildcats dropped a heartbreaking series at Texas Dallas last weekend, dropping all 3 games by 4-3 scores after leading each game 3-1. LC has been plagued by bad weather conditions and had to cancel 3 non-conference games this week. And with rain expected Friday, the team has pushed back its final home games this weekend. The Cats host Hardin-Simmons Saturday in a doubleheader starting at 1. It's also the annual Autism Awareness Game. Then, on Sunday, Senior Day for the Cats starts at 1 p.m. as well. LC will likely have to win both this series and the one next weekend at ETBU to secure a berth in the ASC tournament. The LC football team has been working hard this spring, already getting prepared for the 2015 season. Wildcats Media's Matt Bridges has this story.
Despite big changes on defense and offensive line, Louisiana College Wildcats have come into spring practice with a new enthusiasm and excitement about the upcoming season. Louisiana College football team is coming off a 6-4 finish in 2014. Gone are assistant coaches Brian Wallace and Clay Matchett. Justin Charles moves into the solo role of defensive coordinator. He'll look to replace several key players lost to graduation, including All-American defensive back Ira Jewett, all-time interception leader Shaq Lewis, and most of the linebacking core.
I feel like we haven't lost anything, and we're not rebuilding, we're reloading. I mean, Coach Charles stepping right in. You got me and Rich on both of the corners. You got Cora coming back for Shaq and Trent stepping back in. We're running a 4-2-5, so everything's really fitting in place with the defense.
That new defensive scheme will allow the Wildcats to feature more of their speed and athleticism in the defensive backfield.
We fell right into it. We feel like coming from the 3-4, stepping into the 4-2-5, putting more DBs on the field and more D-line down was the perfect fit for our defense.
On offense, the Wildcats will look to replace 4 of their 5 starters on the offensive line, including ASC Lineman of the Year Brandon Porsche. But in the skill positions and at quarterback, the Wildcats should be loaded.
Of course, having Easton back for a third year is really key in that, you know, he knows all of the checks and knows the voids and coverages, where we want to go with the football in the pass game, and just his level of leadership.
You come out here, you know, do what you got to do, execute your plays, execute your plan, and ultimate goal right now is to beat defense every play. So we keep doing that every day, get better as an offense, and then, you know, take it on to next fall.
Adding to the already deep receiving core is the return of Maurice Cooper, whose speed will complement the already talented group of Shed Davis, Farron Jones, Ladarius Gardner, and Jake Dunbar.
I think this spring got more tempo and we have more like connection with each other, more chemistry than I did last year. Having most of our starting receivers back and just having a whole nother year working with them, we got a lot closer.
Feel good about our backup spot, Lane Landry. He's a year better and doing a lot of good things. Got quality running backs and Cooksey and Silv.
Despite the number of changes and new faces, the team feels it will make a strong run at a conference championship and a return to the Division III playoffs.
A lot of excitement, a lot of energy, a lot of enthusiasm.
We embrace everything. We embrace competition, and we're looking forward to winning a conference this year. We're going to get after somebody this year. It'll be a fun thing to do and a fun thing to watch.
The Wildcats will close their spring practices with their annual 7-on-7 tournament on April 25th. Here at Wildcats Stadium, I'm Matt Bridges reporting for Wildcats Media.
While the LC football team prepares for next season, former player Shaq Lewis prepares for a chance to continue his playing career.
Former Louisiana College All-Conference safety Shaq Lewis finished out his career as a Wildcat with an outstanding senior year. breaking LC's career interceptions record with 14 and single season interceptions record with 6. Now Lewis has the chance to pursue a lifelong dream of playing professional football, not an opportunity many Division III players get.
It is harder coming from D3 just because of the level of competition. But, I mean, if you have talent, they'll find you wherever you're at, D1, D2, D3, it doesn't matter.
With pro days at Northwestern State and McNeese State, he was able to showcase and even do better than the prospects at McNeese State with a 36-inch vertical and a 10-1 broad jump.
But it was a good experience going out there at Northwestern and being able to compete with those guys out there and seeing the scouts and, you know, talking to some of them and just giving everything I got, leaving it all on the field and leaving it up to God, everything in his hand right now.
With former Wildcat teammate Jeremy Unovich playing in the National Football League with the Green Bay Packers, Lewis hopes to follow in those steps and wants those coming up behind him to take advantage of every moment here if they wish to do the same.
Just don't wait to the last minute to get all you can out of everything. Don't wait. Bust your butt. Everything matters. The little things, it all counts, it all matters.
Lewis says that keeping the faith through this time is what helps him get through two-a-day workouts as well as a full class schedule.
It's been a whole process, you know, just grinding, working hard, and praying and staying on top of everything with school because I'm still in school right now, and I'm just hoping for the best.
He currently wears one piece of jewelry to help remind him that a greater power is in control.
I wear this bracelet every day. God has this. I know he in my corner.
And that's a look at Sports Mart. Next week, hopefully, we'll learn about where Shaq is heading after the NFL draft. You know, hoping for good news.
Yeah, we'll be watching.
Of course.
Absolutely. That's awesome news for him. Keeping things going, it's shaping up for a summer filled with superhero movies, and our own Wildcats Media Entertainment correspondent, Taylor Freed, has a story from the box office.
Last year, theaters across America gave us a ton of superhero movies, ranging from action-packed to just plain hilarious. And it looks like they're going to do the same thing this year.
I'm Taylor Freed, and this is your Wildcats Entertainment.
First up, we have Avengers Age of Ultron. In this movie, we get to see Earth's mightiest heroes team up again to battle the evil Ultron and his robot army. But it's not just Ultron they have to worry about, it's themselves. We're gonna see loads of Avenger on Avenger action, and it just looks amazing. Next on our list is Ant-Man. Yeah, I know, it sounds ridiculous, but hear me out. This movie is going to be amazing. Director Joss Whedon, the guy who gave us The Avengers, said this script is the best Marvel has ever produced, and it's going to be this year's Guardians of the Galaxy. It's going to have action, it's going to have comedy, and it's going to have ants. Lots and lots of ants. If you're looking for a funny superhero movie that's just a little bit different, this movie's for you.
I'm Ant-Man. I know. It wasn't my idea.
Next up, we have Fantastic Four. Now, this movie looks dark, it looks gritty, and it just looks amazing. We all know the story of Reed Richards and friends trying to do some science-y nonsense. It goes wrong, and they get their superpowers. Science always seems to be, like, the main problem in superhero movies. I don't get it. This movie is coming from the same guys who gave us Days of Future Past, so I'm really excited. This movie just looks fantastic. Anybody? No? Okay. That's your entertainment report. For Wildcats Media News, I'm Taylor Freed.
Thanks, Taylor. We have one more newscast coming up at the end of the semester, but for right now, that wraps things up for this week. For Wildcats Media News, I'm Mark Klein.
And I'm Carolyn Thornton.
I'll see you later.